The new woman is a multi-layered figure about whom historians have engaged in a great deal of debate. To what degree was she sort of a cultural invention rather than a social reality? How new was the new woman? What did it mean to talk about the new woman? There is, I think, a new woman who emerges out of the war again on a very fundamental level. She is now enfranchised in Germany in a way that she has not been before. She is officially a citizen. She is also working out of the home in public in a way that is different than before. It's not that women hadn't worked before, they had. It's just that now women are much more visible. They are visible on the streets. They are saleswomen in department stores. They are clerical workers and secretaries in offices. They are artists and photographers and cabaret singers on public stages. They look different. They shave their legs. Gillette razors are introduced to Europe from America. They cut their hair. They wear different fashions that are more androgynous. Their bodies seem to be different. They engage in gymnastics. They engage in modern dance. They drive cars at times. They are economically extremely important for precisely the new economy of the post-war period in two ways. First of all, because they are the new workers in rationalized industry on the assembly lines, and precisely those industries that are the ones that they will also consume the products of. The new woman is economically very important. She has a changed political role. She has to be addressed politically because she will, in fact, vote. And she is socially and culturally important in this period because she is identified, I think, in a triple way as the villain, in a sense, of a crisis of modernity, as the victim, and also as the salvation. What do I mean by that? The villain in the sense that women are now visible in jobs, which makes it seem as though they are taking away work from men. In fact, we have a sex-segregated labor force, and women are working in positions like saleswomen, standardized clerical workers, or on the assembly line, in fields where actually that hadn't really existed before. But they are, the very fact that they are working and they are trying to lead rationalized, efficient households, they're trying to combine motherhood and family and work, means that they are becoming more machine-like themselves. They are also rationalizing their lives, which means that they no longer seem to be the haven in a heartless world. They are becoming tougher. They can't be as nurturing as the fear. At a time when it seems like men really need to be nurtured after the war. So in that sense, they appear as the villains of modernity. They're almost the avant-garde, the vanguard of modernity. At the same time, precisely for the same reasons, they're struggling with a double burden. They are trying to cope with the social losses of the war. They're trying to succor the men after the losses of the war at the same time as raising families and working. And then they are expected to act as the saviors, as the salvation, because if only women manage to put these two parts together, the maternal, the nurturing, the succoring, to put that together with being efficient and fit and quick, then maybe it will be possible to meet the challenges of this technologized and rationalized world. In a sense, it's women's ability or not to cope with the world of the assembly line that marks or is thought to mark whether these challenges are going to be met or not.